Okay, moving on to your tools and techniques now. So the critical steps in your construction of data warehouse, they include your extraction, cleaning, transformation. And in some books, they also include loading. So this, for short, they are called as ECTL. You can well imagine that if you have to understand it, you can use the term ECTL. That would really help you to understand this steps for it. E stands for your construction, C for your cleaning, T for your transformation, and L for your loading. So in some books, loading becomes a part of it, although three are very important: extraction, cleaning, and your transformation. Cleaning are even written as cleansing also. It is similar only. So after the critical steps, loading the result into target system can be carried out either by separate product or by single categories only. So in some books, they take it as a separate part, loading part. So they can use the same products for loading, or they can use some other method to load it. So that's why in some books, they take it as an ECTL, and in some books, they take it as ECT, the critical steps only. So although loading part is also critical only. Code generators. So there are different kind of code generators that would definitely help you to implement these critical steps that includes extraction, cleaning, and transformation. Database data replication tools. So wherever the replication of data is required, that means data has to be kept at more than one location. So whenever the replicated data has to be created, it always includes that data that is really critical. So that in case of any loss of data due to some other technical reasons or maybe some other reasons, your data, you can say the replicated data is also available at some other location. Dynamic transformation engine. Again, you have a different kind of, you can say, tools that dynamically transform your data into your data that is actually required by your data warehouse. So that's again an important, you can say, this critical step for your data warehouse data. Data warehouse database management system integration. A very important step now that we have already studied also. You can see over your previous even flows part that this load manager, it has to use your inflow to load the data into your data warehouse. And during this inflow, this extraction, cleansing, transformation part takes place. And the load manager ultimately loads that data into your data warehouse. So if we move on to your this topic of your integration, that means it's a critical step only. So due to the maturity of such products, most relational databases will integrate predictably with other types of software, because we have already reached a maturity level for your Simply database management system that we are already using. In that case, we can even say that these kind of database management systems can easily integrate with any other type of software. So we are able to integrate these softwares, these products to any other software easily. So requirements of data warehouse, RDBMS. So although we can use the same kind of data warehouse, this RDBMS concepts for saving your data in a data warehouse, but they are not very much valid, because as the need for assessing a very large amount of data is there in case of data warehouse, so normal models that we used in your RDBMS concepts, they are not sufficient for saving the data in your data warehouse using your RDBMS models. So we need to concentrate on your load performance in case of your data warehousing systems. We need to concentrate on your load processing also. We even need to concentrate on the data quality part, because the data that is being that becomes a part of data warehouse, it is being available from a large number of data sources. So in that case, data quality plays a very important role for your data warehouse data. Again, your query performance. Query performance means a large number of queries, a large amount of data is being processed through the query. So that means that defines your query performance. So in case of data warehouse data, again, you have to have a great query performance, because it is going to extract a very large amount of data from data warehouse for processing. So in that case, query performance plays a very important role. Terabyte scalability. Terabyte, because we are dealing with a very large amount of data. We are not dealing with the data in GBs or your petabytes and terabytes. We are dealing with the terabytes of data, that's a quite huge quantity. So in that case, scalability of your model for data warehouse data, it should be there. It should have such kind of tools and techniques that is able to handle data that is available in a huge quantity, and we are dealing here in your terabytes of data. Mass user scalability, again, a large number of users are able to assess such a large amount of data, but that too through your proper techniques and tools that are required for assessing that data. So mass user scalability means it should be such that your users that actually want the data to be mined from your data warehouse, they are able to easily extract that data. Networked data warehouse. So in fact, in our previous introductory part also, we have discussed that data warehouse cannot be kept at one location, and there is no one place where you can have your data warehouse. It is being located at a large number of locations in the world, but of course they are being interconnected through your network. So network data warehouse, again, although it is interconnected, you need to know that maintaining the consistency and integrity of the data plays a very important role. So if it is located at large number of locations, then your network should be network speed should be quite high. Warehouse administration, because we are not dealing with a small amount of data, so we have already discussed also. So if we are not having a good administrator to keep your data in your data warehouse in a proper way and at proper location, in that case, whenever that data would be required by the end user, you might not be able to assess that data. So warehouse administration plays a very important role. Only then that data, whenever that is required by your end user, that becomes that is accessible. Integrated dimensional analysis. Again, dimensional analysis has to be done in what kind of dimension your data is required. Dimension means, let's say sales data is required. Let's say data that is related to supplier is required. So integration of a particular dimension and analysis of that very integrated data related to that very particular aspect only. So you need to have proper tools for analysis there. Then advanced query functionality, that means you need to have normal queries that are not suitable for assessing data through your data warehouse. You need to have your advanced queries that are really using a good functionality to assess and analyze the data in your data warehouse. So normal queries used in your data warehouse data, they are not sufficient for that. Now moving on to your importance of managing metadata or integration. Again, metadata term is your data about data. A very important term, as well as your, you can say, keeping your data, or you can say maintaining metadata is very important, because whenever you have to assess your data from data warehouse, it should always be through your metadata. Only then you will be directly able to locate the data that is required at that very moment of time. Otherwise, you know, such a huge data warehouse, you go on finding and try to extract your data that is required, you might not be able to reach that data because data quantity is quite high. So metadata plays a very important role in integration. So integration of metadata, that is data about data. The metadata is used for a variety of purposes, and the management of it is a critical issue in achieving fully integrated data warehouse. Until unless you are not maintaining your metadata in your data warehouse, then that data warehouse is unusable. You can directly use the term this way, because going into such a large amount of data warehouse and trying to extract required data from a particular location, that would really need metadata to know whatever we want, where it is located, how we have to extract it, and how much it is required, what is the size of that data. So all those things are available in your metadata. The major purpose of metadata is to show the pathway back to where the data began, so that warehouse administrators know the history of any item in the warehouse. Metadata is also playing a very important role to know the history of data. So whenever you come across some of the data from your data warehouse, and if you look into your metadata, there must be some fields or some values that directly highlight what is the source of that data. And that is sometimes required for your, you can say, analysis purposes also, for decision makers also to know that from where this data was in fact extracted and loaded into your data warehouse. Then metadata associated with data transformation and loading must describe the source data and any changes that were made to the data. So during your extraction, I've already discussed your cleansing and your transformation part. So if you are transforming some data from a data source, that transformation part should also be available in the form of metadata into your data warehouse, so that the decision makers or the final users or the end users of that data warehouse should know that this data was transformed from the source from where this data was extracted. Okay, from a particular source, when we extracted that data, we transformed that data before becoming a part of your data warehouse. Metadata associated with data management describes the data as it is stored in the warehouse. So metadata, which is related to your data management, that is also stored in your data warehouse, because data management plays a very important role for assessing different areas of your data warehouse. Metadata is required by your query manager to generate appropriate queries, also is associated with your users of queries. So of course, whenever you are using your different queries to assess different parts of your data warehouse, so again, data metadata is playing a very important role to implement that or to execute that in a better way. The major integration issue is to how to synchronize the various types of metadata used throughout the data warehouse. And challenge is to synchronize metadata between different products from different vendors using different metadata stores. So of course, we are studying that metadata is playing a very important role for assessing as well as your, you can say, query processing by your different end users. But again, we are facing a very important issue over here, that we have to integrate and synchronize that metadata throughout the data warehouse, so that whenever a particular end user using metadata tries to assess data from data warehouse, it always gets good results. So that is a great challenge, because we are dealing with a very large amount of data. So even metadata is also quite huge in case of your data warehouse. We are not dealing with small size of data. So we are dealing with terabytes and further zettabytes and zettabytes of data. So in that case, of course, the challenge is how to synchronize such a large amount of metadata to different vendors also. Different vendors means you have your different kind of commercial users or commercial companies who are providing tools and techniques for managing data warehouse in the data data in the data warehouse. So how metadata is going to play a very important role to assess as well as use query processing to assess that data. So integration is very important. By different vendors, you might be having different kind of products, but you should have a method that can synchronize all these particular vendors into one common functionality, how to manage metadata. The two major standards for metadata and modeling in the area of your data warehousing and component-based development are MDC, that is called as metadata correlation, and other is OMG, that is object management group. So whenever you are, suppose I decide today to form a data warehouse regarding any one of the subject area. So in that case, either I'll have to go for MDC, that means metadata correlation techniques for managing my data warehouse, or I have to go for OMG, that is object management group, and I have to purchase the products for management of data warehouse from either of these two categories. So now in that case, you can see that any data warehouse in the world that might be using at least one of these methods, so that there is standardization for management of data in a data warehouse plus management of even metadata in a data warehouse. Moving further, administration and management tools. A very important part, because without administration and management tools, you are not able to manage a very large amount of data that is present in a data warehouse. So a data warehouse requires tools to support the administration and management of such complex environment. You can see that the environment that is really going to be complex in case of data warehouse, because it is dealing with a very large size of data. For the various types of metadata and day-to-day operations of data warehouse, the administration environment tools must be capable of supporting those tasks. So if we are dealing with your data warehouse, so in case of that, even you can say that there are a lot of day-to-day operations that might be carried out on a data warehouse, but you should have good standardized administration environment tools that would really help you to carry on day-to-day operations in your data warehouse data. So these kind of tools, they definitely would be different from the tools that we have already discussed in your OLTP systems, or you can say that systems which use your Oracle and other databases to save your data at your data sources. So monitoring data loading from multiple sources, of course you have to monitor data that is being loaded from multiple sources. You have to keep in mind the data quality and your integrity checks. So you cannot directly move on to your every data that is being created is of great quality and you have your don't have your any kind of checks in that case. Integrity checks are not there. So you need to have a large mechanism to have integrity checks. Integrity checks means, we have already discussed also integrity constraints in your databases also. You have your different kind of integrity constraints. So they are one of your checks only. And like your primary key, foreign key, or these are your integrity checks. Similar kind of checks are required even in your data warehouses. Managing and updating your metadata, you need to have your tools for properly managing and even continuously updating wherever the metadata is required. Then even you need to have administration environment tools for monitoring your database performance to ensure efficient query response times and your resource utilizations. How your queries are being given good response, how they are able to handle. And of course, you are even able to know that you are dealing with your different query responses in a very less amount of time. You are able to provide the end users with the results. And you are even handling your proper resource utilization for carrying out such operations. So is it clear? Okay, now moving on to your data mart. Again, giving the definition again and moving on to the details of data mart. A data mart, a subset of data warehouse that supports the requirements of particular department or business function. So it is, of course, a subset of data warehouse. It is not a directly your data, directly is not, it does not form a, you can say, part of your data in a data warehouse, but it is an important subset of data warehouse because it contains information about your data that is present at various locations in your data warehouse. So it can be your particular department or a particular business function. It can be related to any of them. The characteristics that differentiate data marts and data warehouse include that a data mart focuses on only the requirements of users associated with one department or business function, while in case of your data warehouse, it includes data that is actually available for that very particular department also, that is for a particular organization also, or more than business function also. So definitely data warehouse is quite large as compared to your data mart only. Data marts do not normally contain detailed operational data, unlike data warehouse. Of course, in case of your data warehouse, you have your detailed data, your lightly summarized data and highly summarized data. But in case of your data mart, you are only dealing with your operational data, and that might be only having your small information or very less size information about your data in your data warehouse. As data marts contain less data compared with data warehouse, data marts are more easily understood and navigated. So we are having a very less information in case of data mart, data in case of data mart. I'll not say information is of course very large, but we are able to understand and navigate data mart easily. And through that, we can, you can say, assess different areas of data warehouse easily, because we are dealing with your data about data in case of data mart. So if we move into your typical data warehouse, data mart architecture, you can see over here. That typical data warehouse and Data Mart architecture together at one location now. So this is the same diagram that we have discussed in your architecture of data warehouse. Only thing over here is the adding part. This part is being added. You can see over here. It includes your data mart that is directly associated with your central part of data warehouse. And it includes summarized data about your relational database, summarized data of your multidimensional database also. This is even called as your second tier of your data warehouse. You can well imagine, although it is directly a part of data warehouse, but still data may include summarized data related to your relational databases and your summarized data related to multi-dimensional databases that will of course be discussing in detail in your coming chapters also regarding your this multi-dimensional data and your this summarized data in case of relational databases. Rest, you can see it is all here. And first tier includes the data that was that we have already studied in your architecture only. So this is the second tier of your this data warehouse. So reasons for creating a data mart: to give users access to the data they need to analyze most often, to provide data in the form that matches the collective view of the data by group of users in a department or business function. So what we have to do is, why we create a data mart is that we need to analyze the data. So in case of analysis, we need to have a data related to a particular department or a group of users who are using a particular department or using some business function related to a particular department at one location. So it definitely provides that information in your data mart. To improve end user response time due to the reduction in volume of data to be accessed. I've already discussed also, whenever we are dealing with your data in a data warehouse, we are definitely dealing with a very large volume of data. So in order to improve the end user response to the queries that are being executed on your data warehouse, this data mart definitely would help you to increase decrease the response time, and that's why improve the performance. So to provide appropriately structured data as dictated by the requirements of end user access tools. So we are able to provide appropriately the structured data in the particular format as it is being required by the end user using that end user access tools. If we are studying that data, or you can say assessing the data through that data mart, because that data mart would definitely help you to easily provide data to the end user in the required format they need, and that's really you can say helpful by this data marts only. Otherwise, what would have happened? Every time a query is being sent by an end user, you need to assess that data in a data warehouse, that all data in a data warehouse to reach your end user need that is required for your handling that query. Normally use less data, so tasks such as data cleansing, loading, transformation, and integration are far easier, and hence implementing and setting up of data marts is simpler than your establishing corporate data warehouse. So you can well imagine, so although we are dealing with the similarity in case of data warehouse and data mart also, but still you need not to go into too much details of data cleaning, loading, and transformation integration techniques for your keeping your data in a data mart. And it is comparatively quite simple as compared to your data warehouse techniques, where you need to perform a large number of techniques for ultimately loading that data into data warehouse. That includes, of course, extraction, cleansing, and transformation. So you can well see that creating a data mart is quite easy as compared to your data warehouse. Further, the cost of implementing data mart is normally less than that required to establish a data warehouse. So if you have to only create a data mart, that definitely would include very less cost as compared to data warehouse. And you can even compare it with in such a way that data mart might not need a large number of locations to keep that data data mart. You might be including only a lesser amount of space is required. Maybe at one location only you can directly establish or keep your data mart data. The potential users of data mart are more clearly defined and can be more easily targeted to obtain support for data mart projects rather than a corporate data warehouse projects. So potential users are those who really need to know detailed information about data, So in that case, that's clearly defined in your data mart. So you are directly so your objective is clear, or your target is very clear when you are forming a data mart, you can say, in case of your this data warehouse. So you are very clear with the concepts regarding your data mart, that you are only concentrating on data about your data warehouse. Still, we are dealing with a large number of data mart issues, although they are comparatively very easy to create as compared to data warehouse, but still there are large number of issues in your data mart creation also, and you are using your data mart in different areas. First of all is data mart functionality. The capabilities of data marts have increased with the growth in their popularity. So as and when data mart was used as your management tool for maintaining data, as well as administration environment tool for data warehouse data, their demand has increased, their capabilities have increased to a lot. So in that case, you need to provide large number of functionality in case of data mart, so that you are popular, your brand is popular in case of data mart creation and usage. Data mart size, the performance deteriorates as data marts grows in size. So need to reduce the size of data marts to gain improvement in performance. So if we compare the size of data mart with your data warehouse, although it is very less in comparison to your data warehouse, still the size of data mart is quite huge. So if we want that our performance is definitely high, in that case, we have to concentrate on one aspect, that the size of your data mart should always be less. And to reduce that size, you need to imply different, or you can say to use different kind of tools and techniques, so that your size in case of data mart should not exceed a particular limit, so that your performance is high. Data mart load performance, two critical components are there, end user response time, and the second one is if you move to the second aspect, that is to increment your database updating, so that cells affected by the change are updated and not the entire MDDB structure. Now we'll be going into detail of MDDB structure in our next lecture only, so I'll not be considering multi-dimensional database structure for short, you can say. So there are two critical components in case of data mart also, that load performance and user response time should be less. That means whenever an end user executes a query, it should be able to get the results in a very less amount of time. Again, in case of second aspect, if you say to increase the database updating, so that your cells affecting the change and update are updated and not the entire multi-dimensional database structure. So we should be able to update only the data mart, this particular field only in your data mart, instead of directly updating all the multi-dimensional database structure that is available in your data warehouse. So that would really be helpful giving your better performance, load performance of your data mart. Although again, it's an issue. We are saying that this we should do, but it's really difficult to implement it, because continuous updation of your data mart is very important also. But then in that case, we also need to know that it should not affect the load performance, or you can say end user query handling process by your data warehouse. So in that case, it's really a great issue. Further issues are user access to data in multiple marts. So you can say that one approach is to replicate the data between different data marts, or alternately build your virtual data marts. So one thing is that you can replicate your data marts and provide it at different locations for access by different users at different locations. Another is you provide your virtual data marts. Virtual means that is actually available at the same location, but when you use your views in case of your OLTP systems, similarly, you can even use your virtual data marts that are directly almost similar to your data mart original structure, but still they are not independent, they are directly related to the same data mart only. So it is a view of several physical data marts or the corporate data warehouse tailored to meet the requirements of specific group of users. So similar to your views only, you can see that there is quite similarity between your virtual data mart and your views. In case of view also, we do this thing only that according to the requirements of end user, we create view. Similarly, according to the requirements of end user, we can create virtual data. Next is your data mart internet or intranet access. So it's a product sit between a web server and a data analysis product. So internet and intranet offers users low cost access to the data mart and data warehouse using web browser. So of course we can even see to it that we can put up data mart and your location between your web browser and your final data warehouse, so that whenever you are going to access your final data warehouse, you should always pass your query through your data mart. So in that case, of course, internet and intranet would play a very important role to assess the data warehouse, and of course the cost would also be very less, because through your data mart you are going to assess directly that part of your data warehouse that is actually required by that user. Another important issue is your data mart administration. Again, organization cannot easily perform administration of your multiple data marts, giving rise to issues such as data mart versioning and your data and metadata consistency, integrity, enterprise-wide security and performance tuning. So data mart administrative tools are commercially available. So you cannot go on using your own kind of data mart tool to assess your data warehouse. You should always use your commercially available data mart tools so that you are able to handle some of the issues regarding your versioning, your consistency of data mart, integrity of data mart, and your organization specific security, even your performance tuning. So you need to, again, it's an issue that when you use your data mart, you have to use your commercially available data mart tools so that you are able to manage your data mart in a better way. Another important data mart issue is your installation part. They are becoming increasingly complex to build. So vendors are offering products referred to as data mart in a box that provide low cost source of data mart tools. So as the requirements, as the needs of your different tools of data mart has increased, it has really become a complex process. So even your installation of your data mart is going to be a complex, quite complex. So in that case, what the vendors are doing, they are now providing data mart in a box. That means related to a particular area only, so that they are low cost, and that is only related to a particular area of your data warehouse. So low cost is there, but of course there are some issues. Again, if you have some customers of some other area, in that case that might not be very much of help to the final users. So this is all about your data mart and today's topic. So I'll be concentrating on the next aspect in our next lecture only.